Good evening. I'm Tana Carli.
I'm Tim Taylor. Thanks for joining us. Here's what's happening.
All right, welcome, Tana Carli, Tim Taylor. It's so good to see you guys back together again.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's only been 40 years, right?
Oh.
Isn't that something?
Goes fast.
So when's the last time that you two spoke or saw each other?
Was at that reunion, Tana. How many years ago was that?
I want to say maybe 4 or 5 years ago.
Talk about how it all came to be, because Tim, you were working with a legendary news team, but it was all men.
Well, yeah, you know, before Tana, newsrooms were traditionally locker rooms. That's really what they were. They were boys' clubs. And then Virgil Dominic, Judd Hambrick moved on, and Virgil had this great idea of moving Tana Carli in, and we were the first male-female anchor team, not only in the city, but I think one of the first in the country.
Then there was that connection that the two of you had. Tim, what did Tana have that was so special and so unique?
I can tell you, it was food. I always loved that.
Food.
She very hit it smart. On the head. Every day when we called her Mama Tana, because when she would walk in the door every day, she had been shopping, and it always included food. So she brought it was like having a mom there. And she fit in with the guys absolutely perfectly.
Especially with Dick and John Telledge and Casey Coleman back at the time. We enjoyed each other's company. And I think that's what came through on the air. I have a picture for you of Dick at our wedding, which you would assume that the wedding, the bride and groom would be the center of attention. But Dick insisted on passing out Woolly Bear stickers to all of us. So I had one on my gown.
Then you try not to laugh during the most serious stories. And Dick would revel in that. He loved chaos, loved it. And he had instincts. He knew when things were going south on the air, and he would be sure to race in the studio and try to break you up. That was part of his charm.
Behind the scenes, he was our waiter at night. I have a picture of that too, with Dick actually taking our orders. Every night he'd come over with a little pad and pencil and go to fine restaurants in the area, McDonald's, Wendy's.
Have to bring it out. Tana will remember this.
I do.
Tana and I won this at the March of Dimes gala. It was a cook-off, and we won top prize for best dessert.
We were given two items. One was a poster, which I still have, and Tim and Kathy have the pan that's engraved on the back. And I mean, we can see that there's the picture of that evening. And it was a very special weekend, because that was the weekend that Joe asked me to marry him.
The truth is, actually, Kathy, it's my recollection that Kathy made that, right?
That's awesome. Let's talk about what you guys are up to now.
I'm retired, yay. And we're living outside of Philadelphia. And our son is about to turn 30 years old. He just got married about 2 months ago. Our daughter, Carli, is 32. And this is the big thing. Because of COVID and the restrictions and everything and work, the ability to work from home, they're all going to be living with us very soon.
We live out in the Aurora area, and the leaves are changing. It's beautiful. I love working outside. Love being out on the golf course. Six adult children and 6 grandchildren, ranging in age from 20. Well, the oldest is going to be 22. The youngest is 6 years old. I retired 15 years ago, if you can believe that. It's hard to believe it's been that long.
It is so good to see you guys back together again, Tana and Tim.
Tana, you look absolutely beautiful. You look the same. 40 years later, and as Bob Seger would say, you're still the same.
And I have to say, Tim, get your eyes examined, please. You need better glasses.